So, of course, an app stands for an application. It can be installed on your smartphones. I don't have to tell you that. I think most of us do it every day almost, and can be used for entertainment, education, and news updates. But how can you use apps really? Again, first point, please. Yeah. So again, apps can be used for your own professional development. You can engage in language learning or any other skill that you are interested in. There are several apps out there. But what is most interesting about apps that I've liked is that they have bite-sized information. Most of them have chunks, as you've rightly identified earlier. Preeta, if you could move on to the next point. Yeah. So the bite-sized information, it's 1 to 5 minutes of chunks of information that is stored specially for the purpose of learning. If you're using apps specially for the purpose of learning, then that's a advantage, I would say. Again, a brilliant option for CPD on the go, for people who are struggling with time. The next one is, again, an element I like about apps is most apps have an element of gamification in them. And I've noticed from my own personal experience that be it adults or children across age groups, we all like playing games, we all like winning, we all like to see how far we've progressed, we like to beat each other's records. And I think that is that makes it a lot of fun. And definitely, if you're having a lot of fun, you're definitely learning more. So that's an element I like about apps. The only disadvantage could be that they may not necessarily always give you in-depth information about a topic or a subject as opposed to podcasts, for example, right? So it's the only disadvantage that you may want to consider before deciding what apps you want to use. I have some suggestions for you to use apps. So this slide is focusing on the apps for your own professional development. So you have the TED Talks. For those of you who have been watching TED Talks on your computers in the past, they also have an app now, and it's full of insightful videos on a variety of topics. There is Evernote, which I have used extensively and I've really loved while I was doing my online distance masters. I often have studied, at airports, in the trains, on my way to somewhere. And Evernote has always helped me make comprehensive notes or even clip online resources and store them in one place. But there are more uses to Evernote. I really urge you to explore. There is Spenzu, which helps you to reflect on your teaching. It also sends you reminders to reflect. I think that will be brilliant for teachers. Of course, there is YouTube, again, a very potentially strong resource to look at classroom videos, posting your own classroom videos as well. However, again, a note of caution there. Remember to keep your learners safe, yourself safe. So if you're sharing something on YouTube, I strongly advise that you keep it a closed access group and share the link only with people whom you trust. If in case you're using that, there is WordPress, which is for blogs. You can read or even post your own blogs and connect with teachers and educators across the world. And there is a Fitkey app as well, which hosts all the information that is there on their website as well. I don't have the logo here, but that's also something you can explore. There is another set of apps for your learners or for your own development. Can we move on to the next slide? There are apps for classroom use as well. Thanks, Prina. So there is one called Sounds Right. This is a British Council app that focuses on your English pronunciation. There is an app called Seesaw where you have, you can have student digital portfolios. And there is a separate app for communication with parents as well. My favorite ones are Kahoot and Quizlet because these are apps that I was talking about. There's an element of gamification. You can review important topics that you've done in the classroom, turn them into a quiz for your learners, and it's really fun. And the last one is Edmodo, which is a social media tool for educators. And there is again a separate app for parents if you want to host homework and you want to share resources or answers. This is just a limited list. There are lots of apps out there. So this is just some of them that I've used. Some of them I know other teachers have used that I've put together.